objection. I'll try and pick up the issues that have been raised by Councillor Sung and Councillor Radford. In terms of waste management and bin storage, those are matters where there is only limited control through the planning process. Our experience in trying to refuse a number of these because of insufficient rear storage space for bins has been that provided there is an area sufficient to accommodate a number of bins, say for example within the rear yard, then that is that has been found by the planning inspector to be acceptable. So we've not been successful on that. In terms of day-to-day management, that is not something that we can control during the planning process for this type of property. And I would suggest it's rather for colleagues, perhaps in HMO licensing, to pick up that particular matter. In terms of car parking, again, Chair, members of this committee will be familiar with the issue around car parking and HMOs. The experience of your officers is that these types of conversion do not attract significant numbers of car owners, and therefore we are satisfied that notwithstanding the lack of off-site car parking, the development should not cause particular problems within the streets in terms of highway safety or congestion. And then just picking up a comment from Councillor Radford about Article 4 directions, can I just emphasise that an Article 4 direction does not of itself change the policy. The Article 4 direction simply brings in an additional level of control over those properties that could otherwise be converted without the need for planning permission, i.e. for those properties of six or fewer. So the Article 4 will bring in that additional control over the smaller HMOs, but the issues that Councillor Radford and Councillor Sung have raised would still be relevant in relation to these types of application of seven or more. And the policies remain the same. The issues remain the same as in terms of the local plan and so on, as you heard on previous applications this morning. I'm happy to answer any additional questions, Chair, but you as a committee, I think, are very familiar with the wider issues around HMOs.
Thank you. Are there any questions on this? Yes, Councillor Inception.
Yeah, could I ask, Don, in relation, I mean, Condition 4, the issues raised by Councillor Sun, doesn't Condition 4 really cover those? Because it does clearly say that, you know, that no waste material shall be at any time stored outside the property, and there should be a bin store for the bin. So, I mean, that condition really, I mean, it does cover those points that Councillor Sun made, didn't it? And hopefully, I mean, they will be enforced, those conditions.
Yes, it does. I think the reality is the difficulty in day-to-day enforcement where people put their bins out. It's very difficult in a practical sense to enforce against that if there is a breach of this type of condition. This type of condition is normally associated with the larger those accommodation, student accommodation and so on, where you get a different type of bin. But I think these are the normal sort of weed bins that the council provides. And I think in terms of ensuring they are kept off the street on days other than bin collection is in practice almost impossible to enforce through the planning process. I've not known of an occasion where we have to do that.
In that case, I mean, would this be an issue for the local landlord licensing scheme, you know, to, if you like, make sure that they comply with the conditions that they're being given on the planning?
If it's a planning condition, then it should be for the planning service to enforce those. I just think the reality of that type of condition, in reality, although it's on as a condition, I think it will be hard for us to... for example, you might have a scenario where somebody puts out their bin a day or two before the bin collection day. Are we practically going to enforce against that? every single time that it takes place. The reality is probably not. So the condition there, yes, it is there, and it is for us as a planning service to enforce that, but I think it might be one of those that is perhaps more challenging than others to enforce against if there is a consistent breach.
Okay. So, can I move that the recommendation be approved? Is that agreed? So, can we move on now to another one in Moscow Drive, 146 Moscow Drive? And can I invite Alan Roberts to come forward to address the committee?
I'm prepared to speak,
but... You're here if
we
have any questions.
Yes, that's right.
So can I invite our planning officer to address this meeting?
Again, Chair, the email from Councillor Radford related to both the items on the agenda, so just report that. And again, Chair, very, very similar issues. On this one, the rooms aren't all en suite, so this is shared bathroom type accommodation. I'm not sure if anyone is going to speak on this, but yeah.
I think Councillor Sun wanted to speak. I don't know if Councillor Radford wanted to speak again. So if you would like to come up, Councillor Sun, and then if there's anything that John needs to address, you can come back on it. And the same goes for Councillor Radford.
This is a retrospective planning application, and I'll be honest with you, I hate retrospective planning. They're basically saying we've done this and that's the end of it. And these standards are a lot below all the others that we've been going through, typically with 8 beds, 3 bathrooms. And this type of property is always problematic. And 5 of the rooms today look on that site look double. And I know the planner will constantly tell me that they were limited to 8. You can put anything in. They can't enforce a bin. Why can they enforce people going in those houses? So it could go to as many as 13. I actually went down there yesterday to take a photo, so if it's okay, could I show the committee the photo? Because of its same retrospective region. There's been more complaints on this property, but this is anecdotal because neighbours don't report as much. You know, they don't actually go through the proper sites. But you speak to a neighbour and they'll tell you it's problematic. The back, which I couldn't access yesterday, apparently is full of rubbish, which causes rats. And again, it's easy to put these things saying you can't enforce them. We then have to bring up to environmental. So the cost then comes back to us time and time again. I think on this particular one, I would like to see a lot more thought go into this application. In fact, if you read the application, you could have written it on the back of the five packets. It was honestly that lazy. Even I can't believe how easy it is to get an application like this through. And that's it. Thank you.
Are there any points or comments that we would like to make? No? Okay. Thank you, Councillor Summer.
No. We can get the waste management, sorry. I didn't realise that was an issue. The back was terrible when it was first purchased, and it has been improved a lot. But any recommendations we can improve them?
Yeah. Well, we'll take that as a guarantee it's going to happen.
Yeah,
soon then.
Yeah,
right.
I didn't realise that the waste management was like that.
Can I invite Councillor Rushman to come forward, please?
Problem actually reiterating or just to confirm some of the points councils are making in this particular locality. But the other thing is, as we get to that point in Oxford Drive, there is now such a concentration of HMOs, we actually are having really serious problems with traffic congestion. People can't get in and out of the road. You've got to bear in mind there is only one access road into this site. There's a clear box on Queen's Drive, which can get very congested. People come down Moscow Drive to access all the houses on Michael's Hill, Northgate, and the like. The only other way to come up is go right down to Guernsey River to Derby Lake. So all that row on the road to Moscow Drive that, by the SL station, there is real congestion. And if there's any people or vehicles delivering to the locality, getting into that kind of effectively that status sealed way to access points, it can be really, really congested. I think we'd also ask to bear in mind that rather large building, five doors down, that is the former St. James Church site, that has 16 apartments. Okay, I appreciate most of them are not with colours, but on that row going from the St. James's site up to the SO station, apart from 150, virtually every one of those properties is an HMO. So, 74, I think, was one of the better quality conversions. That was a little problem at the children's house. The majority were HMOs to a degree, and we have real problems, not just on this particular house and the house on this right there, but actually that whole row has been absolutely horrendous for agricultural behaviour, dumping on the front of the gardens, no congestion, no parking, close to two other cars, and it has become a really deteriorated part of Oslo Drive. In that sense, I think this application, dare I say, compounds the problem, or sanctifies the problem, sanctions the problem, rather than taking action to bring up standards in this particular county.
So can we come back to you, John, if you've got any comments to add?
Chair, exactly the same issue really as the previous application. Just one other highlight in relation to the bin storage issue. I don't want the community under the misapprehension that, you know, we can't do it. The condition is on, and the condition is enforceable. So it's simply trying to emphasise the point that in practice, if we get this problem consistently, you know, it might be challenging for your officers week in, week out, and we might need a sort of coordinated approach with colleagues to enforce this type of condition. So that's one point. I apologise if I said that rather clumsily earlier on. All the other issues, Chair, think are similar to the item you heard previously. Happy to answer any further questions.
Councillor Rainey.
I'm not sure who is exactly responsible for pictures and things, because it's clearly not in the bins they have property to set HMO. So whether that's the tenant or it's the owner to supply the bins, I'm not sure if you know which it is.
No, I don't, Chair. And I think this is my point about it being some wider community departmental approach to the issue of waste being stored on the one-week payment. You know, the highway colleagues will be involved, there will be colleagues from refuse collection and so on. So, to answer your specific question, I don't know who supplies the bins. My understanding, my guess, and that's all it is that it would be the bins are provided by the council. Yeah. But,
yes, I think the owner has to ask for more bins to be provided, and hopefully this is what it's going to go.
So I was
going
to say,
we've had the answer taken today.
Can I ask the owner that he make sure there's more bins to be just to say, just to say,
yeah, we can
try.
Yeah. If it's a big problem, we can get a, it's only council bins.
So, there being no further questions, can I move that the recommendation be approved? Is that agreed? Thank you. Now we move on to our final item, item 14, 110 Garmoyle Road, Liverpool 15. And I don't have anybody down here to speak. No? So, can we hand over to planners, please, do it.
Thank you, Chair. Just one piece of housekeeping. Councillor Brown, Lawrence Brown, has submitted further comments that he considers the proposal doesn't have sufficient amenity space. There's an absolute car park which is detrimental to highway safety. There's a negative cumulative impact in the area from Pinos in the Dales area. Again, this is about the fourth point today. We're well versed in the issues surrounding Pinos. This one is specially compliant. It has enough room in certain annexes certainly to accommodate the facilities that seven persons would need in this particular occasion. There's been no recorded complaint either at this premises or in the immediate vicinity of the application site. Bear in mind that it continues to use one, so it is operational. There's no recorded complaint from the Hino licensing team or from Environmental Health. It's in a location that's relatively well served by public transport, Smithdown Road, having many buses that go into the city centre, as well as there being lots of local services nearby. So in this particular instance, in the absence of any recording, you can find that the premises or within the vicinity of the site, and then spatially compliant, your officers don't see any reason to recommend refusal on this, so we're recommending approval, Chair.
Are there any questions? So, can I move that the recommendation be approved? Is that agreed? Thank you everyone for your attendance today, and that concludes our business.